Hi, welcome to my notes Oracle DBA YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about partition table management in PostgreSQL. What is partition? A partitioned table is a logical structure used to divide a large table into smaller pieces called partitions. Why we need partition? Managing a large table is a big challenge, but maintaining a good performance and manageability for those large table is an even bigger challenge. In this situation, partition is a solution. Let us consider we have a large table with partitions. If something goes wrong, rest of the data will be available. At the same time, it ensures the availability for good performance also. The types of partitions are range partition, list partition and hash partition. Range partition: partition a table by range of value. This is commonly used with date and numerical values. Let us consider we have a customer table. We want to get recent customer details. So we can made a partition based on the customer ID or based on the purchase date. Here the partition key is customer ID or the date of purchase. List partition: partition a table by list of known values. That is, when the partition key is a categorical value. Example, we have a global sales table divided into regional wise. Here the partition key can be a country code or city code. Each partition will be defined the list of codes mapped to it. Hash partition: partition a table using a hash function on the partition key. This is especially useful when there is no obvious way of dividing data into logically similar groups. Example, if we have a table called sales is often accessed by a product, that table might benefit from a hash partition on the product SKU. Here we are going to see range partition in detail. It is widely using it. It is very useful. We can store the data based on the range. The partition can be have any name associated with our table. As per our requirement, we need to create two tables with different manner. First, I have created a table name called customer. In that customer table, we have a multiple columns are there. In that, we need to consider two aspects for the range partition. First one, the first aspect is the customer ID. Based on the customer ID range, we can create the partition. And the second aspect is the register date. We can create a partition based on the date range also. Here we have created a table partitions based on the customer ID, which is associated into the customer table. If you see the picture, we have created a three partitions in the name of C part 1, C part 2, C part 3. Each partitions having the minimum and maximum value. The minimum value is inclusive, the maximum value is exclusive. Based on the requirement, we can add a new partitions. At the same time, we can drop any partitions also. For a better performance, it will allow to perform detach and attach on the available partitions. Let us switch into the machine. I just connected my database by using PSQL. By using slash L, we will get the list of available database details. In that, I am going to connect dev database by using slash C. Once we connected the dev database, we just want to know what are the available tables in the database. By using slash dt, we will get the details. As a result, we have a one table name called a rupee. By using slash d, we can able to see the structure of the rupee table. So we are going to check either the rupee table having partition or not by using d plus. As a result, the rupee table doesn't have any partition. So I am going to create a customer member table with the partition key of customer ID. Once the table has been created successfully by using slash dt, if you see the result, it will display the customer member table and rupee table also. Let us see the table structure of customer mem by using slash d. As a result, it will show the partition type is range and the partition key is cust ID
and the number of partitions is 0 because we never created any partitions as of now. Let us, we can create the partitions for customer member table. So I am going to create the first partition, which is name called C part 1, based on the customer ID of customer member table, which is the range of 0 to 1001. Here the 0 is minimum value, which is inclusive. 1001 value is the maximum value, which is exclusive. I just want to verify whatever the partition we created now. So I am going to use /dplace of the customer member table. If you see the result, before it was showing number of partitions are 0. But right now it shows the partition name and the range of value which is given by us in the time of partition creation. Now I am going to create another two partitions in the respective name of C part 2 and C part 3. Once we created two partitions successfully, to verify that by using /dplace customer mem table, the result will display with the respective partition name and the range of values. I'm going to insert some of the values for my customer mem table randomly. Once the insert has been completed, I'm going to issue commit. It will throw an error because auto commit is enabled. I'm going to select my customer mem table. If you see the result, it will display inserted values of my customer mem table. I'm going to check available table list on my dev database by using /dt. If you see the result, it will display the customer mem table along with the partition table also. I am going to select all the partition. If you see the result, whatever the value has been inserted on the customer member table, those value has been stored on each partition based on the partition key of customer ID range. Now I am trying to insert a new value on the customer mem table. The value which I am going to insert is maximum value of the partition 3. As a result, it will throw an error because the maximum value is always exclusive. In this situation, we need to add a new partition or we need to go with the default partition. Once we define the default partition, we could not able to add a new partition on our table. So what I am going to do, I am going to create a new partition with the range of 4001 to 6001. Whatever the value we are going to insert in between the range, those value has been inserted successfully. Now I am going to verify the partitions of the customer mem table by using /dplace. If you see the result, whatever the partitions we have added, those partition name has been displayed with the respective range. Let's assume we have a large table in that we need to access particular range of data for reporting purpose. In this situation, we will face the performance issue. To avoid that, we can detach or attach any partition based on our business requirement. I am going to detach partition 3. Once I have detached partition 3, I am going to verify by using /dplace of my customer mem table. As a result, the partition 3 does not appear on it. At the same time, whatever the value has been stored on the partition 3, those value does not show on the customer mem table. Now I am going to attach the partition 3 of my customer mem table. Once I have attached successfully, I am going to verify by using /dplace of cust member. If you see the result, we can able to see the partition 3 with the respective range. Now I am going to verify the customer mem table by using select. If you see the result, whatever the value has been stored on the partition 3, those values are still available. Now I am going to drop my partition 3. Once I have dropped it, I am going to recreate with the same name with the respective range of value. Once I have recreated successfully, I am going to verify by using /dplace of my cust mem table. If you see the result, the partition 3 table was available with the range of value. Now I am going to verify the data of my customer mem table. If you see the result, whatever the range of value has been stored on the partition 3, those data are not available. The result, whenever we perform detach and attach the partition, the range of value has been stored over there. It won't be lost yet. But the same, we dropped and recreate the partition, those data has been lost it. Now I am going to drop the customer mem table. Once we dropped it, I am going to verify list of available tables by using /dt. If you see the result, the customer mem table and the all partition table also dropped it, because the parent table is customer mem table, the partition tables are child table. If we drop the parent table, at the same time child tables also dropped it automatically.